Kaillie Humphries, two monobob World Series races, two wins. Tell us, how different is it here in Koenigsee to last week in St. Moritz?
It's very different. I mean, all the tracks are different. I'm happy that I've got experience and I understand the difference, especially having to switch between two man and monobob now. This is our first time on all of these tracks in monobob, especially the S curves coming out of S4. I feel like I'm Tokyo drifting around that last corner just with that back end. But it's taking some getting used to. Definitely this track, some of the corners you have to drive differently than others. And we don't have many runs, but it's super fun. I love this track. I love Birch's Garden. And yeah, I'm happy with today's result.
Does experience really help? If you're used to changes in the track and adapting to that really quickly, does that help when you get into the monobob and it feels different?
I think experience helps, and then how fast of a learner any pilot can be. Every single time we come here, the ice is slightly different. So now you're just adding a different discipline, one we don't know how the sled's going to react. So the faster you can learn and adapt, the better. Experience helps. I have a bit of an idea. I've been in lots of different situations on this track multiple times, so I have a plethora I can pull from, but overall, it's a lot of it's just going to be who can learn the fastest.
What about runners? What do you do to try and keep the sled under control? The trend for fat runners presumably doesn't work when you've got a sled that's so light and skitterish.
As long as you've got skinnier runners on the back, again, the radius of bobsled runners is not sharp, contrary to popular belief. They're about the radius of your pinky finger. So I have smaller ones on the back, fatter ones on the front. A lot of it's going to be driver preference. How fat can you go while still maintaining control? So it's going to be pushing those limits. The ice conditions play a factor. It was warmer today than in our training, so you kind of have to watch the weather as well and just see what happens.
And now you've got to take out the monobob chip and put in the two-seat chip for tomorrow's race as well.
Yes, definitely. I'm excited for it. It'll be good. It's different. The sled handles differently. I'm in a new sled this week, so that's also an added addition for two-man. But overall, it'll be fun. It pushes my limits as a pilot. Especially for me, that challenge is huge. And being able to push my limits, my skill, get a different driving feel makes me a better athlete. And, you know, I'm very happy that I've got this opportunity. And I think it'll be a lot better for all of the women to be able to have this monobob. As you saw today, Korea, you know, you've got the Swiss up and coming. Overall, the girls are, they're adapting, they're learning. But it's really cool in monobob to see a lot of those other countries and have it all kind of mixed up.